What up, friends? Welcome back. Today, I'm super excited to show off the brand new ATOTO S8 MS flagship head unit that ATOTO graciously sent us to review. It's an Android-based powerhouse of a head unit that features things like wireless CarPlay, Android Auto, GPS, 4G connectivity, Wi-Fi, multiple Bluetooth inputs, and a built-in digital signal processor that is legit mind-blowing. I mean, seriously, this thing really sounds amazing, and it's very comforting to know that sound quality is actually, you know, at the top of the list, because what's the point of having a radio without sound quality, in my opinion? I mean, come on, I'm sitting in front of a Denon receiver. So sound quality is a big thing for me, and if you know my channel, you know that. But add on top of that an optional ODB2 interface, which connects to your vehicle's onboard diagnostic system and allows you to do a lot of things. It displays things like coolant temperature, engine RPMs, a lot of stuff. This isn't going to work for the application that I'm putting it in today, because I have ODB1. We're putting it into my beautiful, lovely 1994 Buick Roadmaster, and it's a little tricky. It's kind of a custom install. Check out the next video for that. We're going to do full install, full how to hook up everything, basically anything installation related, and we're going to be showing how to install it in multiple vehicles. So first, to better introduce it to you guys, let's go ahead. I already have it installed in the Roadmaster, and I want to show you some of the features and how to integrate with it, and then we'll do a proper sound test using a good microphone. Definitely stick around. I think if you're anything like me, you'll be very surprised. And for the price, $289, you're really getting so many features that it's really mind-blowing. And one thing I did mention to ATOTO was that I wasn't gonna lie about the quality or anything like that. Well, I actually was very surprised. Let's check it out. Okay, so as you can see, it was a beautiful install. Like I said, check back next week, you'll see how I actually did that. One of the things about Android head units is their boot up time. So I'm gonna turn the car on now. Let's see how long it takes to boot up. There we go, we're ready to go. So I guess we're gonna first start off with kind of all the features. Now, pretty much it is an Android, you know, based unit. So if you're used to Android, you're gonna be pretty well used to this and able to integrate into this. This is what I was talking about before. This Torque app is completely awesome, and I kind of want to get this out of the way first because I don't really have the ability in this vehicle to use this unless if they have an ODB1 connector. I don't think they do. Something that, you know, I will maybe get into, as well as the HD reverse cam that ATOTO offers, which is literally, it's pretty cool. You can literally download anything onto here. I've seen people run Netflix. No, you can actually play like games, PS2, whatever, if they have, you know, the composite inputs. It has your Google Assistant. I mean, there's so many different things. Google, the radio. I don't get any radio stations out here, so that's not really a big thing for me, but the radio stations that I did actually find, it came in just fine. There is a bunch of things that you can do with the radio. You can turn up and down the AM and FM sensitivity. You have a regular game player. Now, another thing that this does have is it has GPS, but it has 4G connectivity, which means you can buy a prepaid SIM card from, you know, Verizon. Well, I don't know if about Verizon, but T-Mobile, whatever, anything like that. And you can actually have, you know, data on this. You can play YouTube. You can do whatever you want. I don't suggest doing that while you're watching, but, and as you can see right now, I'm getting notifications from YouTube. That's because I've got my account linked up with this and I'm hooked up to my home's Wi-Fi. And then one of the things that you're probably watching this for and that's drawing you to this is Apple CarPlay or Android Auto. And that is so easy to hook up. Either one, like I have an Android, and look, it's already wanting me to connect. But in order to do that, all we do is go to the car link. And then it takes a second to connect. But once it does, this might be blurred out because I don't want you to know where I live. But there we go. You've got maps. You can search anywhere with all that jazz. Then to get out of CarPlay, just go ahead and hit the lower left corner, which is very much, I mean, if you're used to Android, you can integrate with this very well. And then hit exit. And then that'll kick you out. But like I was talking about, what about actual sound quality? Okay, now I have Manifested by Netflix queued up, and for the sound quality test, I'm also going to go into the equalizer and try to see if we can hear over the M-Audio mic, any difference from the DSP and all the different changes that we can do. And we'll also show you how to change and manipulate the subwoofer and all of that. So we'll go ahead, let that start. And I do have my subwoofers hooked up. Okay. So now, first off, we have time correction. That is with time correction on, and the microphone is right about, you know, at ear listening level to where I'm at. So we will turn it off. Turn it back on. I don't know if that's going to come through, but next we will check bass boost. I don't have those all turned off. So the sub, check this out. So this is the low end, this is the high end. If you want to cut out them low frequencies, you can turn it that way. Now you bring it back, we got all the low frequencies. If you want to cut the higher frequencies, bring that down. And then you just got only the low. And then this middle one, you can turn it down or you can turn it up, which I think is really cool. Now this sound field is really cool too. Okay, so I'm almost positive between YouTube compression and just the fact that this is a monaural or a mono microphone, I don't think you're going to be able to hear the difference in any of that, but it is absolutely amazing. I never realized how much of a difference it would make before hearing it. Whoa, it got dark all of a sudden. Well, all right, I've been checking out this Track Tribe group. This one is called Dance Electric. We're going to do another sound test, and I'm not going to yap through this one, so let's see how it sounds. I don't really know how well that came through. I guess it's something you just got to hear with your own ears, but I'm actually very impressed. A couple of things I forgot to mention is it has an octa-core processor, which means you can do a lot of multiple things at once. And there's multiple Bluetooth inputs, meaning you can have your phone on and have another Bluetooth device on, and it won't, you know, cut off your phone. It's designed to have multiple Bluetooth devices connected to it. One of the things, which I didn't even mention upon the plethora of other things that I didn't mention yet, is ATOTO also has a little steering wheel control that kind of clips onto your steering wheel and gives you steering wheel controls on, you know, if your car doesn't have that. But if your car does already have that, they have adapters to connect it and connect just about anything else you could think of. It also supports screen mirroring and USB tethering. If you come back next week, we're going to be doing a full install on my 94 Buick Roadmaster, as well as I'm going to show you how to install it in different applications. Check the link in the description, and there's also a discount code there. That's about all we have for now. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And come back next week, check out the install, and like always, thank you very much. Have a good one.